We begin with a high alert at the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad after protesters launch a dramatic attempt to storm the compound. U.S. Marines firing tear gas at the crowd after the roof of a reception area was ignited. It was the second day of a siege that began after U.S. airstrikes on Iranian-backed targets in Iraq. This night vision video showing Marines flown in by Osprey aircraft from Kuwait and the Defense Department announcing they will deploy an additional 750 troops to the Middle East, quote, immediately. ABC News foreign correspondent James Longman leading us off.
A second day of rage at the U.S. Embassy in Baghdad. Tires burned, fires lit. U.S. troops shooting tear gas to disperse hundreds of protesters. Smoke once again shrouding America's most heavily fortified embassy. With the damage from the violence clear, U.S. security personnel on high alert, ensuring the crowds don't breach the walls. U.S. helicopters firing flares to keep the crowd at bay yesterday. And overnight, President Trump left with no choice but to deploy new reinforcements to the Middle East. About 750 soldiers from 82nd Airborne Division in Fort Bragg, North Carolina. That's on top of more than 100 Marines already flown in.
Well, I think it's been handled very well. The Marines came in. We had some great warriors come in and do a fantastic job, and they were there instantaneously. This will never, ever be a Benghazi.
U.S. interests defended for now, but their hatred for America runs deep. These are the supporters of Kataib Hezbollah, a militia group supported by Iran and which was targeted by U.S. airstrikes over the weekend. The president holding Iran directly responsible for the embassy attack, threatening payback. Kataib Hezbollah, just one of an army of militia groups with Iranian backing. Tehran's influence and power runs deep in Iraq and across the Middle East. One of the reasons Iraqi security services have been slow to defend their American ally.
All right, James Longman is joining us live again tonight. And James, you're learning the situation is improving outside the U.S. Embassy tonight.
Yeah, that's right, Whit. For now, things have calmed, although the embassy does remain on lockdown. But this is part of a bigger picture of increased tensions with Iran. The regime has escalated its hostilities since President Trump ripped up the nuclear deal and hiked sanctions. It's a high-stakes game that will only intensify over this coming year. Whit.
All right, James, our thanks to you tonight.
Hi, everyone. George Stephanopoulos here. Thanks for checking out the ABC News YouTube channel. If you'd like to get more videos, show highlights, and watch live event coverage, click on the right over here to subscribe to our channel. And don't forget to download the ABC News app for breaking news alerts. Thanks for watching.